I'm excited to introduce you to SAS Visual Analytics. If you have access to Visual Analytics, I encourage you to follow along with me. Your environment may already have all the files used in this demo. However, if you don't see them, please visit our SAS Software GitHub page. The SAS Viya Quick Start repository provides the files used in our demonstrations and instructions to load them into your environment. To open Visual Analytics, click the Applications menu in the upper left corner and select Explore and Visualize. From this welcome window, you can open an existing report or create a new report. I'll select New Report. Visual Analytics consists of three main areas: the left pane with icons for working with the overall report, a canvas where you build the report, and a right pane with icons for working with specific objects. The canvas displays one or more page tabs across the top of the report. Reports use data that is loaded into memory. In the data pane, there are options to either add data or import data. If I click Import Data, I can load files from my local operating system, such as Excel or CSV files. If I click Add Data, then I can select from tables that have been loaded into memory. I'll search for home_equity, then select the table. I'll browse the column list to verify this is the right data, then click Add. The data pane now displays all the columns or data items in the home equity table. Data items are organized by type. Character columns and numeric columns with a date format appear as categories. Distinct counts appear next to each category. Numeric variables appear as measures. Based on what I know about our data and the report objects I want to create, I can use the data pane to modify or create new data items. Previously, I explored this table using the Information Catalog application. I'm interested in analyzing the loan status column. 0 is a loan in good standing, and 1 is a loan that has defaulted. Later, we'll explore the relationship between loan status and the other columns associated with the loan application. The values of loan status represent a binary response rather than a measure. I'll edit properties for the loan status data item and change the name to loan status code and the classification to category. This data item now appears in the category group and includes two distinct values. A consumer of this report might not know what the 0 and 1 values represent. I can create a new data item that assigns more descriptive labels to the raw loan status codes. I'll right-click Loan Status Code and select New Custom Category. I'll name the item Loan Status. The first group name will be Current. And I can type the value 0 and press Enter. Then I'll click Add Group and type Default in the name field. This time I'll click the Choose Values button, select 1, then click OK. Any values other than 0 or 1, I'll choose to show as missing. Now we can choose to use either the raw loan status codes or descriptive labels in our report. There are many other ways that you can alter or create new data items. For example, eventually I would like to view the number of loan applications for each month and year. If I look at the format applied to the loan application date column, it displays a 2-digit day, a 3-letter abbreviation for month, and a 4-digit year. Instead, I'll change the format to MMMYYYY so that the displayed values will be a 3-letter month and 4-digit year. Notice that I have a column for the U.S. state. If I would like to map values based on the state, I can change the classification to geography. I simply need to change the name or code context to U.S. state names. And 100% of the data values are mapped to the appropriate geographical region. Finally, let's look at the measures. The default aggregation for all measures, with the exception of frequency, is sum, which means that as we build visualizations that include these measures, the calculated value would be a total. Because each row in the data is a separate loan, it makes more sense to look at the average for all measures. To change the aggregation method, I can select the checkbox for each measure, or I can use the More menu and choose Select, and select measures with same aggregation. Then I'll right-click and change the aggregation to average. We're now ready to explore our data and learn more about the data items and their relationships. If you're like me, I love to look at the raw data to see what I'm working with. I'll start by selecting the Objects pane and then drag List Table onto the canvas. I can use the Roles pane to select the columns that I want to add to the list table. I'll select All and then click Apply. I'll drag Loan Status to the top of the list so that it's the first column. I can scroll to view the different columns and values, or I can click on any of the columns, such as State, to sort the table in ascending or descending order. Or if I right-click on a column, I have several additional options. I love the ability to add cell visualizations. I'll right-click Age of Oldest Credit Line and select Add Cell Visualization and Bar. I'll also add a heat map to Amount of Loan Request to color code the distribution of the values. You can customize cell visualization in the Options pane. I'll double-click page 1 at the top of the report and type Home Equity Data to name the report page. Now let's create a collection of graphs to explore our data. I'll click the plus sign to create a new page. And then from the Data pane, I'll drag Loan Status to the canvas. An auto chart is generated, which means that Visual Analytics selects the appropriate graph based on the data type and values. In this example, the auto chart is a bar chart, but I can easily change the visualization. I'll select the Object menu and choose Change Bar Chart to Pie Chart. In the Options pane, I can customize the graph. In the Pie section and under the Data Labels section, I'll select Percent of Total Values and increase the text style size to 12. We can see that approximately 20% of the loans default. Let's create a few other report objects. In the Data pane, I'll select Amount of Loan Request and drag it to the right side of the canvas. The auto chart is a histogram, which is a great way to view the distribution of the values. Next, I'll drag Loan Application Date below the histogram. This time, the auto chart is a line plot that tracks the frequency of loan applications over time. This downward trend is expected because homeowners were more likely to refinance rather than apply for home equity loans during these years of declining interest rates. You don't have to always start with an auto chart to create a report item. From the Objects pane, you can select from a long list of options. I'll drag Bar Chart below the Pie Chart. I can use either the Assign Data button or the Roles pane to build the graph. I'll add Job Category to the Category Role. Under Measure, I'll remove Frequency and then add Amount Due on Existing Mortgage and Value of Current Property. The length of each bar represents the average measure because we previously changed the aggregation. I can further customize the graph by selecting Options. I'll change the direction to Vertical. These static images are informative, but it would be helpful to see how they differ by region. In the Data pane, I'll right-click Region and select Add as a Page Control. Now I can click each region button to see how the graphs change. This page is a good first step to understand our home equity data. I'll double-click the Page 2 label and type Loan Exploration. Let's dive a bit deeper into the geography data. I'll create another new page and name it Geo Analysis. I'll drag State to the canvas and a map is created. I'll select Roles and add Frequency as Size and Amount of Loan Request as Color. I'll return to the Data pane to create another new data item, this time a hierarchy. A hierarchy enables you to drill into categories within your data. I'll add the largest grouping first, which is region with 4 values. Then I'll add division, followed by state. Notice the name automatically includes the hierarchy values. I'll click OK. If I drag the region, division, state hierarchy to the canvas, Visual Analytics creates a bar chart. I can click on each bar label to drill into region and then division to see the corresponding frequencies of loans. I can even take it one step further and select actions. If I select the checkbox for geo-coordinate, then each time I drill into a particular bar on the region chart, the map will update based on the filtered data. So easy. We've done a great job exploring this historical loan data, but my next question is, how does the data help to predict loan status? If I return to the data pane, I can right-click Loan Status and select Explain, Explain on New Page. Visual Analytics generates an automated explanation that indicates that the three factors most related to loan status are debt-to-income ratio, number of delinquent credit lines, and value of current property. I'll name this page Predict Loan Status. If I want to create a preliminary model to predict loan status, I can select the Object menu and select Duplicate As, and then choose from a list of modeling options. I'll go with gradient boosting. This model enables us to continue in the analytics lifecycle. The Options pane allows me to customize and fine-tune the model. Or from the Object menu, I can select Create Pipeline to hand the model off to Model Studio for deeper analysis and model comparison. Another great feature about this model is that I can derive predicted values and probabilities. I'll select Derive Predicted, and then click OK to add predicted and probability data values to the report. The new data items are available in the Data pane, and I can include them in my Home Equity Data List report. I'll click on the table, select the Data Roles pane, then select Add. I'll choose both the predicted and probability data items, and the columns are added to the table. So now, if a new row is added to the data without a determined loan outcome, the model will predict the result. Let's save the report and try it out. I'll click the Save icon and select My Folder. I'll name the report My Home Equity Report and click Save. I'm currently in edit mode, so I'll click the View Report button in the upper left corner. If I look at the Loan Exploration page, notice how all the charts update as I select each region. And on the Geoanalysis page, the map updates when I select a bar representing a particular geographic area. I'll go ahead and close the report. I realize that we've packed a lot into this report, but we've just scratched the surface of what is possible with SAS Visual Analytics. If you would like to view other completed sample reports with even more objects and actions, navigate to SAS Content, Products, SAS Visual Analytics, and Samples. And if you would like to learn more, please visit the Learning Center. We have several resources available for you to expand your visual analytics expertise.